Well, it's the number one ranking in preseason. I told the team yesterday. Really comes down to they're not going to give rings for the preseason number one. We're going to have to earn this. Certainly, everybody's looking at us because we have a lot of talent on paper. And with the transfers coming in, with Elena back healthy, with Kayla Miller back on the squad and healthy, there's a lot of expectations. But we are excited. We're anxious to get going. And we want to prove that we deserve that number one ranking. So it's great to be a Blue Hen right now. And we are ready and raring to go. Falling short in the finals, the CAA finals last year, was good for the team in the aspect that, you know, we didn't have our full team. Some people came off injuries. Some people came off illnesses. And we really tried to patch it together to get to that point. We hit our stride, especially at the end of the year going into the tournament, and made a great tournament run. But bottom line was we weren't 100%, and we were trying to get there. So I think it gave the team some confidence. Certainly we were disappointed because we thought we could pull off the upset. But now being the front runner, it's exciting knowing that we do have all the pieces together. And as I said, we want to gel this team and be at our best again at the end of the year so we can make the run for the championship. You know, the Preseason Player of the Year award is deserved by Elena. Certainly she had a great summer. She's healthy again. Being picked that back-to-back years certainly shows the respect that the coaches and the conference have for her. I think she's earned that respect from what she's done both at Delaware and on the national scene, winning the gold medal with the World University team. So, you know, she deserves it. I hope that she's anxious, which I know she is, to get this season started. And, you know, we're just really excited. And as I said, it's an honor well deserved for her. I think this summer and the experience with the World University team only helped her gain confidence. You know, she's coming off of the illness. Certainly missing half of our season last year was a disappointment to her, as well as us. And then she scrambled at the end of the year to try to get back in the flow. So I think she's looking forward to hopefully having a very healthy season and really showing what she can do for a full season, because she has not, in the 2 years she's played college basketball, been healthy either one of those 2 years. She's missed a number of games her first year and then missed half the season last year. So keeping her healthy, I think she's really, really excited. And yes, her confidence is very high from the summer and playing with USA Basketball. Lauren Carra, as a junior this year, there's a lot of expectations of her as well. She's played through some injuries and has just been the nails for our team. I mean, she is just so tough. We need that on this basketball team. We need her to continue to really stretch herself offensively, look to score for us, which she is more than capable of doing. When Elena was out and ill, she averaged 16 points a game. I need her to have that aggressive mentality on the offensive end. But she has been everything we thought she would be coming out of high school. She's been, as I said, tough and stable, and we're going to need that going into the season, and we need her scoring. This season, we're looking to be a defensive-minded team. Although we've got some weapons, which I'm very happy about, you only win championships and you only win big games when you can defend. I think that's shown across the board for every team in the country. So we've got to really focus on the defensive end. The offense is going to come. We've got some people that can put the ball on the basket. Now it comes down to team chemistry and playing defense and being very stingy. So our team understands that. We've talked about that. And we're anxious to get the game started. It's the toughest non-conference schedule we've ever had, you know, with the likes of Penn State, Maryland, Wake Forest, Providence, Villanova. The list goes on and on with Big East, ACC. So it's a challenging schedule for this group. And we're looking forward to it.
Anytime we do play Delaware, there's a lot of intensity in that game, which is a very healthy rivalry for both programs to really get each other going. So I think this year is going to be the exact same. I wish that we could play each other twice a year, because I think it's really good. Good TV is good basketball for the programs.
You know, the CAA conference is going to be outstanding, as it always is. Virginia Commonwealth is right on our heels. They are loaded. They as well have everybody back. Andrea Barber, as well as Courtney Hurt, who had an amazing year last year, leading the country in double-doubles and leading it in rebounding. She's a terrific player, so we'll have our hands full when we play them. James Madison, two-time defending champion, is back. They've got the best recruiting class coming into the conference. They've got some transfers of their own. So it's going to be very, very competitive. And then you have others. Shantae Evans, who's going to play for USA team in the Pan Am games in just 3-4 days, you know, she's leading Hofstra. So there's a lot of teams that can win this. Our team is well aware of that. And so we've got to come and show up every single night because that's how good CAA is.